Hello, I'm just about to put my order through for the new Chicken Tikka Domino's pizza. And as it's two for Tuesdays, I thought I'd get myself the Tex-Mex as well, because it's good. I have placed my order as of now, which is 20:05. And is it going? And my order is placed. Now I've just got to wait for Metro Bank to verify my order. And come on, Metro Bank is verifying your transaction. And there we go, thanks for your order, there's my order number. And let's wait for the new pizza. Of course, I didn't have to wait because I live quite close to Domino's Pizza. In fact, this close. Domino's Pizza is there. If I zoom in, yeah, I'm lazy, so what? I can actually see it making a pizza. Look at that. Can I zoom in any further? Yes, I can. Ooh, steady hands, steady hands. Look at that. Can I zoom in any further? That is how close I live to Domino's Pizza. I can see him making a pizza. I am so lazy. And now it says it's out for delivery. I am no stranger to ordering Domino's pizza, and I'd say that for every 10 times I've ordered, only once I've then had to call and ask for directions. I don't know who's worse, me ordering despite living so close or them not knowing where I live. The thing is, I have to go downstairs to collect my pizza and cross the road because they always get the wrong address. Which means I'm practically walking half the way to Domino's Pizza. A good nearly 10 minutes. So I've got a feeling they're going to ring for directions again. If I get a knock at the door, I am actually going to tip them. Actually, yes. But I've not had the door go. The phone's not gone off. I think it's going to be a phone call. I want my pizza. Yes, I could have eaten it by now if I'd have actually got off my fat ass and gone over there. But I didn't. I ordered it because I'm lazy and I'm sat on my fat ass waiting for my pizza. I can hear a clomping up the stairs. Could it be my pizza? I'm gonna go ahead and see if it's my pizza. I wanna take a couple of quid. My gosh. I will actually have to step outside. No, it won't the pizza, man. Hello? I still tipped the guy anyway because I didn't want to come across like some sort of skinflint or mean. So here's my pizza. They both come with a standard garlic and herb dip. Garlic and herb dip, despite it being what's the top pizza? Despite it being the chicken tikka one. I should show you it really, shouldn't I? If I'm reviewing it. There you are. Smells tikka-y. How do you describe chicken tikka smell? Oh, come on YouTube. Google's so amazing and you'd have thought they'd have come up with smell-o-vision by now, wouldn't you? I'd say it's a moderate chicken tikka taste. But it's not hot. And it's also not hot as in steaming, piping hot. It's at that nice, just eat now taste. Mmm. You know where it's missing? In the crust, it should have some sort of essence of chicken tikka. So it's just something in there, at least. I like it. The top two pizzas I normally get is either pepperoni passion, obviously, with some sweet corn on it. You gotta get pepperoni passion with sweet corn. It's so good. Tex-Mex is my second favourite. I hate the look of onions, so I'm not looking at the onions. It's quite oniony. It's alright, really. But just alright. I think just needs that extra bit more of a in there. Just needs a bit more oomph. There's the fat police, me being a lazy fatty for ordering it, despite living less than a minute away. I'm just a tinsy wincy bit underwhelmed. There's not a lot of chicken on it. No. It just needs that extra oomph. That's a bit disappointing. I paid $15.99 for this. It's an 8-slice one. It's very Moorish. It's good. But it's not. It's not one I'm going to order again. Not one I know that I can get the pepperoni passion or the Tex-Mex, which are my favourite too. I'd have something else. This one's somewhere in the middle. I'm a bit disappointed actually after spending all that money. It's quite thin. It's not hot and spicy at all. It really isn't. It's really quite mild. So don't get this if you think, oh, I like a nice spicy pizza, because it's not. Oh well, I think that's my review. It's different. It is nice, but I just don't think I'll be getting it again. But it is nice to have something different, isn't it? Oh well. Thanks for watching, please comment, rate and subscribe. And I think you should try this chicken tikka pizza because it is good. It's something different from what they usually do at Domino's. Bye. Well, now I've eaten all that pizza, this is my last little bit left. The garlic and herb dip is just so out of order. It should be mango chutney or something. There's no excessive heat in this pizza. It's just alright, it's just nice. But because it's Domino's, it makes it a bit overpriced. Nah. I won't be getting this one again. But I do recommend you try it if it's on a 2 for Tuesdays thing. Give it as your second pizza. Want something different. Thanks for watching. Bye.